speeding bullet.
If you only knew the power of the dark side.
More powerful than a locomotive.
Hulk! Smash!
Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound.
There's more to them than meets the eye.
It's Superman!
Cop cornered him, said, "Oh, you didn't think that this could
Hey there, boils and ghouls. Here we are at another excellent Chuckle Script show here on Rhode Island Free Radio. That was a little Traveling Wilburys and one of my favorite songs, Tweeter and the Monkey Man. Of course, we got with us George Garner and Nurse Misery over to my right.
Woohoo.
We are going to bring up a subject in a little bit, one that needs to be touched on. See, we are a comic world and all things nerdy, so we're going to get to this. But at first, I think I would like to start a segue out about the movies I have caught this week. And yes, The Avengers being one of them. And
yep, with, same here.
With all anticipation, I'll get to that in a second. But watched a couple awkward ones on Netflix. One I can't remember the name of, but one that stuck out in my mind that I watched was called Stakeland. This was like a vampire-zombie hybrid. And it, what, about 2.5 hours, Nurse Misery?
Give or take. Almost three.
Really, really good movie up until that last second.
It was literally the last 60 seconds make and you want to cry.
Don't you hate when that happens?
Oh. The rest of it was so amazing. I can just stop it 60 seconds before that and be okay with life.
And
it
I'm
was
hoping,
that good, I could ignore the bad ending.
Right, and I'm hoping the reason he did this is to make a sequel to it, because it is a definite new outtake on vampires.
Is there such a thing?
There is. This guy has reinvented the wheel for us, and I enjoy it, the way that he set it out and put it in your face.
It's, okay, so is it something we can discuss, or is it just one of those see the movies?
See the movie, and it is not your typical romantic vampire
movie.
Okay,
they've gotten away from that.
It's way away from that. It is not your typical, like, it's, they don't give too much reasoning how the vampires come to be. I mean, there's no background story. It just, the movie starts, boom.
Yeah,
there
we
they
were
are.
Talking about that exact thing last show, that we're sick of background stories.
Yeah, there's very little background to it. It just, it's in your face within the first 3 minutes.
And it is gory.
And it continues to be in your face.
It is definitely very similar to Wes Craven's Vampires gory.
And they managed to find, now you said vampire zombie hybrid. Does that mean they make a connection between the two concepts? Or?
No, there is no connection, but it does take a little bit on what the zombie movies do with the virus. That's all I'm going to leave it with.
Gotcha, okay.
That's the only part that they take away from the zombies, and the fact that the things actually hunt you in herds. So it's not like vampire picking you off at a time.
It's the intelligence factor is kind of what changes it a little bit. So
yeah,
it's
they
the
aren't intelligent.
It's more the zombie mentality, but vampire powers.
Okay.
And it's really, really good. I wish I could remember the name of that insane asylum one we watched, because that was incredible, too. It had an awesome cast on it. I'll have to remember and put it up on the blog. That was good. I also watched a two-parter that the nurse got me, Superman Batman comic. Yes, it was a cartoon movie where the Joker almost takes down Superman. That was a good one. That came out probably, I'd say, 1990, so it's been out a while. I just finally caught it. I'm catching up with things, guys. Catching up with the times. However, The Avengers, I cannot say enough positive feedback for this. I went into this thinking, George, that they were going to screw Voltron's colors. They were going to screw with his way of being. They're going to screw with the Vision storyline. They did mess up a lot of stuff, but as far as the Ultron staying Ultron, they kept it there. And I enjoyed that.
Okay, if I was that EBIT fat guy that always rates movies, I would, with a thumbs up or thumbs down, I would say I love the original, the first Avengers. And this one, I didn't like quite as much, but it's up there.
Yeah.
It had really good stuff in it.
You're right. It wasn't as good as the first one, but it still keeps your attention. And with me, I love violence and I love fighting. And there's nothing but violence and fighting throughout this whole damn movie. I mean, there's a couple little breaks here.
Except that there is. See, you know, that's the same mistake. I mean, I know what you're saying, but that's the same mistake that some of the critics made when they were talking about, oh, it's just that. Well, it's not. Every so often, there's some, you know, character moments.
A little bit.
Which moves just enough. Just enough to keep it moving along.
Right. And they didn't go into great detail on how Ultron came to be, which, thank you.
Thank God.
I didn't need that story, that great detail. They just put him there. They added a little comedy to the character a little bit, which is typical Marvel. And a lot of people say, oh, I don't understand why they're adding comedy to a villain. Well, if you read Marvel comic books, villains do have their moments.
Yeah, except that Ultron never did.
Well,
actually, Ultron was a pretty...
They gave him it.
I understand why, though. I mean...
Someone needed the good one-liners.
The only thing I would say that I didn't like about Ultron, and someone's going to kick me for this.
I might agree with you. Go ahead.
It did have a little bit of that Transformer. Thank you.
Thank you.
Transformer feeling to it.
Oh, man, yeah.
It wasn't so much the comic book as it looked like something Megatron may have given birth to.
Yeah, I mean, it's perfectly clear to me that either somebody on the storyboard or the actual, you know, creators, them, you know, the actual graphic guys themselves, somebody came over from the Transformers series.
Well,
I don't know. You know, it did. It fell. And the thing that gives it away, because I guess, and you know, I was trying to figure out why, you know, why so, was I feeling this so much? It's the way Ultron talks. In other words, the Transformers is the only series where the robots, their mouths move like humans because they try to give it that cutesy look. You know what I'm saying? And I think, and that's the mistake they made with Ultron. In other words, it's...
They humanized them.
A little bit too much.
But other than that, I got to say the movie's definitely a 9 out of 10. I mean, I can't give it a perfect 10 because I'm a comic nerd. And it does not follow the Ultron storyline at all.
Well, I would give it the 7 out of 10 because I was actually that aggravated about... Because I remember I predicted that I wasn't going to like the Ultron portrayal from the get-go. But I would give it the 7 out of 10, except that it gains back a point or two because there was this awesome... If somebody, anybody that hasn't seen it yet, keep an eye out for it. There's this awesome action sequence around the middle with that runaway train.
Yep.
Like that, you know, there's about 5 minutes of film in there. That's what a superhero movie action sequence looks like.
Now, as far as I know, the next Avengers movies, for those folks that are fans of this, is not going to be the star-studded Avengers movie you got in part two.
I thought not.
A lot of the characters that are in part two will not be in part three. So keep that in mind. And that's not just saying the actors. That's saying the Avengers themselves that you love from the first and second movie, more than half of them will not be in it.
Well, which they basically gave you the lineup for the next movie in the last scene of this one.
And that is your typical Avengers. If you're an Avengers fan, you know that there's 84 of them. So they're going to give you a couple more. For the looks of it, on the other good news, before we go down to a music break, I saw the listing for Captain America Civil War. There's something like 16 superheroes that they are putting in that movie. That is incredible. And when we come back from music break, I'll give you a list of some of them that they're going to be putting in there, and you're going to be shocked at some of the characters that you're finally going to get to see interact with some of the Avenger characters. But let's go down to a little Iron Maiden here on Chuckles Crypt, one of my favorite songs. And this one goes out to all the soldiers that have passed because Memorial Day is a couple weeks away. So I'm going to play a couple songs and pay close attention to this because at the end of the song, there is a portion put in there that is not Iron Maiden. But if you can guess who the singer is at the end of this, maybe I'll send you guys a free autograph or something. So let's go down to Iron Maiden's The Troop.